like to tell you about Sayyidina Sheikh and about, you know, talk about, I would like to tell you an intro about them. However, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلِ الْأَرْضِ هَوْنَا, that the slaves of Rahman, they walk on the earth in a very polite manner. And Sayyidina Sheikh, حَفِظَهُ ta'ala, they do not like their students to elaborate about them, to talk about their miracles, etc. So without any further ado, and they like to skip the intro, so without further ado, inshallah, I would invite them, inshallah, now to inshallah come and to inshallah honor us with their blessed speech and with their prophetic inherited knowledge. Ameen Abul Alameen. We welcome Sayyidi Shaykh. Nare Takbir, Nare Risalat, Nare Haydri, Ulamai Ahli Sunnat.
أعوذ بالله من السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين, وأفضل الصلاة وأكمل التسليم على سيدنا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين, ورضي الله عن أصحابه أجمعين, وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. أما بعد, فالسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. The best is, I always like to start with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, that's authentic, where Imam al-Nasa'i and others narrated. إن أحسن إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها. So the best is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's go through the book of Allah Jalla Jalaluhu, and then we'll see. I know they asked me to speak about the night of Nisf Sha'ban and its specific virtues, whether there are authentic specific virtues for the Nisf Sha'ban, or is it just an entirely a bid'ah actually to have a Nisf Sha'ban or anything allocated to Nisf Sha'ban. So we'll talk about that inshallah. But let's start with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال الله الكريم في كتابه العظيم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولقد أرسلنا موسى بآياتنا. ولقد أرسلنا موسى بآياتنا أن أخرج قومك من الظلمات إلى النور وذكرهم بآيات الله إن في ذلك لآية لكل صبار شكور. Those are ayahs in Surah Ibrahim. This ayah is in Surah Ibrahim where Allah says, وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا مُوسَى بِآيَاتِنَا. We have sent Musa with our ayahs, the meaning of the Quran, of the ayah here. يعني Allah sent Musa with the Torah. Torah is an ayah. Al-Quran al-Kareem, ayatun uzma. The books of Allah are the greatest ayahs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oftentimes we look for things and we're chasing the wrong things. Yani people talk a lot about inshiqaq al-qamar. Al-qamar was split for a Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No problem. We talk about, trust me, I will bring it if I feel different. People talk about the water coming out of the honorable hands of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to give over 1,000 people the whole army water. By the way, this is the most honorable water that earth ever had. It's more honorable than Zamzam. By definition, Zamzam comes from earth, and that water came from the hands of the Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's not, everyone has its, the kulla minna maqaman ma'loom. Everyone has their one maqam. Zamzam has its maqam, lakin that water, the Muhammadan hands, ala sahibiha, afdhalus salati wa salam, is different. Naam. لكن among the most important miracles of Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, if not the absolute most important, was Al-Quran Al-Azim. This is the greatest ayah. So sometimes we put that aside and we go to different things. It's important to look at the book of Allah Jalla Jalaluhu. Allah says, وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا مُوسَى بِآيَاتِنَا. We sent Musa with the Torah. That's a big ayah. What else do you want? La, you can argue, say no. Here the meaning of the ayah is Allah sent Musa with actually other kinds of miracles, such as the cane. Yani he has the cane. He went to Fir'aun. You all know when he went to Fir'aun. And Fir'aun looks at Musa alayhi salam and he sees an old man with a cane. Are you telling me you are the messenger of God, the creator, the Lord of the Lord? Musa tells him, yes. Look at you. The old man dressed like this, like a shepherd. Will you have a cane? لَوْلَا نُزِّلَ عَلَيْهِ أَسْوِرَةٌ مِّنْ ذَهَبٍ. Al-Quran speaks on behalf of Fir'aun. Yani Fir'aun said, if you are truly the messenger of the Creator, how come you don't have chains of gold around you? Notice how the Fir'auni thinking is. Fir'auni thinking is how much money, how much gold you have, is how much worth you have. Fir'aun. Well, many people who follow Fir'auni madhab until today, they still think how much money you have is how much worth you are. Like, what Fir'aun didn't realize is that this cane that Musa alayhi salam had, that was not simply a cane just to walk, to help him walk with. Yani if he would throw it, it would change into a snake. If he throws it in the water, it would split the ocean into two ways so he can go with his people across the Red Sea. Sure. Because Fir'aun doesn't see the haqiqah. Fir'aun sees what his eyes show him because his heart is blind. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا مُوسَى بِآيَاتِنَا أَنْ أَخْرِجْ قَوْمَكَ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. We sent him our ayahs. Why Al-Quran says that? Take them from the darkness into the light. لأنه موسى is light. موسى عليه السلام is light. نور. And Allah sent him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends the messengers to illuminate the path. Remember what Allah says? وَضْمُمْ يَدَكَ إِلَى جَنَاحِكَ تَخْرُجْ بَيْضَاءَ مِنْ غَيْرِ سُوءٍ آيَةً أُخْرَى. Ya Musa, طبعاً we all know al-anbiya alayhim salam have a different intrinsic nature than we do. Why? And you don't have Jibreel coming to you. Jibreel has not come. Assalamu alaikum. I want to talk to you today. Or Israfil or me, or the other angels. لكن الأنبياء عليهم السلام, they have Malaika coming to them. And because Malaika are from Nur, the jinn are made from fire. The human beings are made from clay. Well, Malaika are made from Nur. Because Al-Anbiya have to be versatile. They have to be versatile. They have to communicate with the malaika. They have to communicate with the jinn. They have to communicate with the human beings. They communicate with others. They have a nurani nature as well, in order for them to also be on the same tajanus with the malaika, so they can understand the malaika and sit with them and speak to them and communicate with them. No? And therefore Allah says to Musa, وَضْمُمْ يَدَكَ إِلَى جَنَاحِكَ. Put your hand in to your side and then show it to people. تَخْرُجْ بَيْضَاءَ مِنْ غَيْرِ سُوءٍ. It will come, so it will have. Then show it to people. Show it. It will come بَيْضَاء. Yani the Quran says بَيْضَاء, which means nur comes out of it. That even some of the say it overtakes the sun and the moon's nur. That's just the hands of Musa, huh? just to put your hand like this, it will overblind them with the nur, a nur that they haven't seen. Ayah. Ayah. These are among the verses or among the miracles that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave his anbiya alayhi wasalam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Musa alayhi salam that miracle with the cane, with the snakes. You know what happened. The whole magicians went into sujood. Some other time we'll talk about these events. Other when he crossed the ocean, etc., etc. Allah saved them many times. So Allah says here, "An akhrij qawmaka min al-zulumati lan-nur." Take your people from darkness to light. What? وَذَكِّرْهُمْ بِأَيَّامِ اللَّهِ. And remind them with the days of Allah. The ayah means, remind them with the days of Allah. Allah has days. Aren't all days the days of Allah? No. كله خلق الله. This is all the خلق of Allah. It's true. لكن there are specific days that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the people ni'mah more and gave people, tested people more. Those days, Al-Quran Kareem orders Musa, remind your people, bring them from darkness to light and remind them with those days. يعني انت today, for example, is not like Laylatul Qadr. Laylatul Qadr, khayrun. But all the nights are the nights for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah specifies some time and specifies places and gives them more than others. يعني the 10 days والفجر وليال different than other days. Being in Mississauga is different than being in Mecca or Medina. Different. But Mississauga and Mecca, they're all the khalq of Allah. They're all the creation of Allah. So what's the difference? Well, Allah put more barakah in Mecca and Medina than He put anywhere else in the world. And Allah put more barakah in Laylatul Qadr and Laylatul Nisf of Sha'ban than He put in other nights. Now we come to what we want to talk about. Now I understand the popular notion of saying nothing sahih came in the night of Nisf Sha'ban. Well, that could not be further from the truth. There are authentic narrations, ahadith, to the Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, indicating the khasa'is or the specificity of the 15th or the Nisf of Sha'ban, specifically with authentic hadith. I had written it, a small booklet about that few years ago, maybe long time ago. So I put some of the evidence there from the book and the Sunnah, and we'll talk about them. Let me start with the first hadith, which Al-Bayhaqi narrates في الشعب with a weak sanad, but Al-Khara'iti narrates in Masawi al-Akhlaq with an authentic sanad, sanad sahih. Through Marhum bin Abdul Aziz, through Dawood bin Abdul Rahman, وهما ثقات, through Hisham bin Hassan, and he's ثقه, through Al Hassan, ثقه, through Uthman bin Abil As, obviously Sahabi, and the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إذا كان ليلة النصف من شعبان فإذا مناد هل من مستغفر فأغفر له هل من سائل فأعطيه فلا يسأل أحد إلا أعطي إلا زانية بفرجها أو مشرك. يعني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم in this hadith says, if whenever the nisf of Sha'ban comes, Allah orders a caller, someone calls in heavens, is there anyone who is seeking istighfar, maghfirah, so I can grant him my forgiveness? Is there anyone who is asking me for anything, so I can give him whatever he's asking? Two things. Anyone who wants, who is doing istighfar, so I can forgive him. Is there anyone who is asking anything? Sa'il, ay mas'ala, whatever mas'ala you have. So Allah says, حتى أعطيه, except مشرك or an adulterer, وليعذ بالله. And this hadith is صحيح, indicating the authenticity of the Nisf of Sha'ban, not like any other night. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم specifies it, and that's very important for us to know. There's another hadith that At-Tabarani narrates in Al-Kabir, and also Ibn Hibban also narrates it in his Sahih. Through Hisham bin Khalid Al-Azraq, he said, we were told by Abu Khulayd, Utbah bin Hammad, through Al-Awza'i, wa Abdul Rahman bin Thabit bin Thawban, through his father, through Makhul the Tabi'i, through Malik bin Yukhamir, through Mu'adh bin Jabal radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, يَطَّلِعُ اللَّهُ إِلَىٰ خَلْقِهِ لَيْلَةَ النِّصْفِ مِنْ شَعْبَانِ فَيَغْفِرُ لِجَمِيعِ خَلْقِهِ إِلَّا لِمُشْرِكٍ أَوْ مُشَاحٍ. Look at this hadith. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows his generosity in the night of the Nisf of Sha'ban to all his creation. He forgives everyone except two. Everyone who asks is exposed in that night, the hadith tells us, is forgiven except two, mushrik and mushahin. Mushahin means those who have quarrels and fights amongst each other. Yani brothers, they're fighting over things. Those are exempt from being forgiven that night. If you have a problem with people, some people, you had issues with the dunya, money issues, inheritance issues, issues like this. This is the time before you ask forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to drop that from your heart and to make that call and say, Akhi, you know what, forgive me. Let's both ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. If you keep that grudge in your heart, you may be exempt from being forgiven of the night of Nisf of Sha'ban, where everyone is forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Except the mushrik and the mushahin. The mushahin is the one who is in fights with other people and his heart is still hateful on other people. And this is among the rahmah of Islam. Notice, Al-Nabi, this hadith is also sahih. Sahih. Ibn Hibban narrated in his sahih. Umakhul obviously met Malik bin Yukhamir. No one of the Salaf said that. He did not meet him. So the hadith cannot be below the Hassan Sanad, inshaAllah ta'ala, يعني as far as classification, where Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us that everyone is forgiven during that night. It's one of those nights where Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells you, you are forgiven, expose yourself to that night. Stay up in that night. Do your istighfar in that night. Do things in that night. يعني open, read Al-Quran Al-Kareem, do all these things. This is what people do during the night of Nisf Sha'ban. Another hadith also that is Hassan, inshaAllah, Ahmad narrates it in the Musnad through Hassan bin Musa, through Ibn Lahi'a, through Huyay bin Abdullah, through Abi Abdullah. Through Abi Abdullah, through Abdullah bin Amr, and the Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يَطَّلِعُ اللَّهُ إِلَىٰ خَلْقِهِ لَيْلَةَ النِّصْفِ مِنْ شَعْبَانِ فَيَغْفِرُ لِعِبَادِهِ إِلَّا لِإِثْنَيْنِ مُشَاحٍ وَقَاتِلْ نَفْسِ. Which means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show his generosity unto his creation the night of Nisf in Sha'ban. He will forgive all his slaves except two people. Someone who's always fighting with others and a murderer. Again, you see this, and the hadith is Hassan ibn Lahi'a is Saduq, as far as I'm concerned, and obviously also Huyay. Do it. There is a nice variation to the hadith, and I know I'm going to keep you through some of the hadith today, but the reason we're doing that is because we have these, ذكرهم بأيات أيام الله, remind them with the days of Allah, where the days of the ni'mas of Allah are there. ابتلاءات الله, as the hadith in Muslim, Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم tells us. The reason for that, there is some notion nowadays to prevent people from being reminded by the days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
يعني as instead of us trying to gather to remind each other with the days of Allah, as Allah says, وَذَكِّرْهُمْ بِأَيَّامِ اللَّهِ, remind them with the days of Allah, the days where Allah's mercy is more is given to everyone, etc., etc. Now sometimes we stay away even from those few days, we try to stay away, and then sometimes we try to cover those days. No, there's nothing specific. What do you mean there's nothing specific? If the authentic ahadith tell you there's something specific, you better believe there's something specific. So I'm going to spend some time with you with the ahadith. And those are all Hassan or Sahih hadith, to say the least. And therefore, يعني nothing is we're bringing is weak. And when it's weak, I'll tell you. This is another hadith also, inshallah. It's very known. That's the most used usually through Sayyidah Aisha, Umm al-Mu'mineen, radiyallahu ta'ala anha, wa radha as-siddiqa bint as-siddiq. Hadith rawah Ahmad wa Tirmidhi and others. And it's, she says that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ يَنزِلُ لَيْلَةَ النِّصْفِ مِنْ شَعْبَانِ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا فَيَغْفِرُ لِأَكْثَرِ مِنْ عَدَدِ شَعْرِ غَنَمِ كَلْبِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows His generosity in the night of Nisf and Sha'ban, and He will forgive for more people than what the hairs of the wool, of the skin, of the sheep, of the tribe of Kalb. The tribe of Kalb had lots of sheep, and more than every, if you count every single hair on their of their wool, on every single sheep of all the herds of that tribe, Allah will forgive more people than that in that night. Now this hadith has many, many narrations. All of them are weak. Before they were all Sahih and Hassan. This one is narrated with many narrations. All of them are, every single one of them has an issue of weakness. But it is known in the science of Hadith, for many of you who know. If there are many narrations and they're all weak, combined together, they amount to something, which many of the ulama of Hadith call Hassanun li ghayrihi, wa rubbama Sahih also. Yani it is good for its corroborative evidence, specifically when we already have authentic and Hassan ahadith precedent before that, establishing that foundation. Now, when we look at that, let's see the Salaf radiallahu anhum. When we talk about the Salaf, the pious predecessors, how did they do? We have authentic narrations, sahih narrations, to the tabi'een, saying that they were doing things extra in the night of Nisf of Sha'ban. Let's see some of them. What Al-Harith bin Abi Usama narrated in his Musnad with an authentic sanad. He says through Abdullah bin Aun, حدثنا أبو عبيدة, حدثنا عبد الله, حدثنا خالد بن معدان عن كثير بن مرة. كثير بن مرة is a tabi'i. كثير بن مرة is a tabi'i who met 70 Badris. 70 of the Sahaba of Badr he met. He heard from Mu'adh bin Jabal and others. يعني one of the tabi'in, some of the tabi'in only met one sahabi. This tabi'i met 70 of the sahaba, but not any sahaba. He met 70 of the sahaba who were in Badr. Higher level of sahaba radiallahu anhum. Imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored him, not any sahabi, but the Badri sahabis. Anyway, هذا كثير بن مرة says, this hadith is authentic. He says, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, يعني authentic to him, لأنه مرسل, مرسل to كثير. He says, إن ربكم يطلع ليلة النصف من شعبان إلى خلقي فيغفر لهم كلهم إلا يكون مشركا أو مصارما. Allah shows a special generosity in the night of نصف شعبان, and He forgives all His creation, يعني all His خلق, except مشرك or Musarim. Mushrik, we have already has come many times, and people who struggle and fight with people, etc., etc., hateful person. يعني hate, شوف الإسلام here, in the tarbiyah of Nisf and Sha'ban, among the tarbiyah of Nisf and Sha'ban is, don't keep your heart a trash can of hate. You, every hate you put it in your heart. I hate this, I hate this, I hate this. So your heart turns to be just a collection of hate. Dump this hate, ya akhi, and love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Exchange this hate for love of Allah and the love of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You'll be happy. But if you put in your heart the hate of this and the hate of that, you'll always be boxed down in this hate. That's among the hadith that tells us today of Nisab and Sha'ban. There's no going around it. If you leave it for the sake, you say, but he hurt me, but he stole my money, but he said this about me, but he did this. It's not about what he did. It's about what you're going to do. What are you going to do? You're going to keep your heart hating him? Or you're going to drop it, empty your heart, love Allah, and ask Allah to forgive you in this night? And you know that if you give something, you drop something for the sake of Allah, Allah will reward you with even better than what you gave for him. That's the point. You have to have yaqeen on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you have yaqeen in Allah jalla jalaluhu, and you know that if you leave something for his sake subhanahu wa ta'ala only, though you are on haqq, but you leave it for his sake, Allah will give you better. Look at this hadith, which is Hassan, now that we're talking about this. And Nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam says, "Ana za'imun bi baytin fil jannah." I am a guarantor of a house in the middle of Jannah. He's guaranteeing you, co-signing. Done. For who, ya Rasulullah? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, "Liman taraka al-mira', for he who abandons debate, even when, especially when he's on the haqq. He knows he's on the haqq, but he doesn't want to do that. He wants to abandon that. So imagine when someone you have a problem with, but you forgive simply for the sake of Allah, knowing that your right will never be lost. Allah will always give you better than what you gave for his sake. But you have to believe in him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, very important. Another one, hadith, isnaduhu sahih ila makhul. Makhul is among the tabi'een. Yani mursal, lakin to makhul it's authentic. Makhul is a tabi'i. So we have now Kathir is the tabi'i. Look at makhul is also a tabi'i. He says also, hadith al-Bayhaqi, Imam Bayhaqi narrated in his Shu'ab, through Zuhair bin Muawiyah, through al-Hasan bin Hur, through Makhul, he says, "Inna Allah yattali'u ala ahli al-ard." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows his mercy on the people of earth in the nisf of Sha'ban. فَيَغْفِرُ لَهُمْ. He forgives all of them, except two. Kafiran aw mushahinan. Again, the same thing. One either kafir or the one who is a hateful person. Look at that. Many of the narration coming again. Another one also, another narration, also authentic to Makhul. يعني مرسل, but to Makhul is authentic. Makhul is a tabi'i from al-Sham. Known Abid, Zahid, everybody knows him. Big tabi'i. Al-Lalukai, narrated in Usul al-Atiqad, with an authentic sanad through Muhammad bin Kulayb, through Mu'tamid, through Bard. He says he was narrating through Makhul. He says, يَطَّلِعُ اللَّهُ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى عَلَى خَلْقِ لَيْلَةِ نِصْفِ مِنْ شَعْبَانِ فَيَغْفِرُ لِلْمُسْتَغْفِرِينَ. Look at this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows his majesty, his generosity on the people in the night of Nisf Sha'ban. He forgives everyone who asks forgiveness. Ask. اُدْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Not only that. وَيَتُوبُ عَلَى التَّائِبِينَ. And he forgives those who repent. Yani, if you want your tawbah to be maqboola tonight, not only forgiving you, but your tawbah, ya astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayya, ya Allah, from this thing I did, tawbah from this. And then the hadith goes to say, again it's mursal, but to makhul it's sahih, وَيَدَعُ أَهْلَ الْحِقْدِ بِحِقْدِهِمْ. And he leaves the people of hate with their hate. He forgives everyone. He who asks him for istighfar, he gives him maghfirah. Who asks for tawbah, he grants him tawbah. And he leaves the people of hate with their hate. Yani, you are people of hate, avoid them. Leave them alone. They're boxed in with their hate. فَيَغْفِرُوا إِلَّا لِمُشْرِكِينَ أَوْ مُشَاحِنْ. Now, these are in general what the Salaf used to do. Staying up the night in the Nisf of Sha'ban. So let's go closer to see some of the points. Obviously, as Muslims, we're encouraged to stay up many nights. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he talks to his Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what does he tell him? قُمِ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. Stand up the night except a little. نِصْفَهُ أَوْ انْقُصْ مِنْهُ قَلِيلًا أَوْ زِدْ عَلَيْهِ وَأَكْتِرِ الْقُرْآنَ ترتيلا. So in general you are required to stay up the nights anyway. Look at Al-Hafiz Ibn Rajab رحمه الله in Al-Lataif. He says in page number 196, يستحب إحياء ليلة نصف شعبان جماعة في المسجد. It is encouraged that people stay up the night in the masjid as a group in the night of نصف شعبان. This is Al-Hafiz Ibn Rajab Al-Hanbali رحمه الله. And he says وقد وافقهم من أئمة الاجتهاد. Many of the أئمة of اجتهاد agreed with that, such as إسحاق بن راهوية. That's Ibn, that's, so we're talking about some of the ulama. Obviously you say, what do you mean staying in the masjid and spending the night there? Remember the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Imam Muslim narrated in his sahih, majtama'a qawmun fi baytin min buyutillah. Not a group of people that gather, this hadith is sahih fi Muslim, not a group of people that gather in one of the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yatluna kitab Allah, they recite the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa yatadarasunahu baynahum, and they talk about it between them, إلا نزلت عليهم السكينة, except the sakina, the comfort and the tranquility descends on them. وغشيتهم الرحمة, and the mercy of Allah will overshower them. وحفتهم الملائكة, and the ملائكة will be surrounding them. وذكرهم الله في من عنده, and Allah will mention them. Huh? If this is in general any night, how about a night that is specified that it has extra fadl, extra khasa'is? Huh? Naam. And you all know also the hadith that Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu mentioned. The hadith is also في صحيح Muslim, that he says, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ مَلَائِكَةً سَيَّارَةً. Allah has malaika that are touring. They travel, that's all they do. They go, they look for, يَبْتَغُونَ مَجَالِسَ الذِّكْرِ. Their job is, they look for where there is a majlis of dhikr on earth. فَإِذَا وَجَدُوا مَجْلِسًا فِيهِ ذِكْرٌ قَعَدُوا مَعَهُمْ. Those malaika, they go around earth until they found a people sitting and they're making dhikr of Allah. If the hadith says, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam tells us in the hadith, if they find a majlis, a session of dhikr like this, they sit with them. The malaika sit next to these people. Huh? And you might not see them, but they're sitting with you. Huh? طيب. وحف بعضهم بعضا بأجنحتهم, and then they call each other, the malaika call each other, come, we found what we were looking for. So they will stack each other next to each other until they reach heavens. فإذا تفرقوا عرجوا وصعدوا إلى السماء, until they go everywhere. Allah asks them سبحانه وتعالى, and he's all knowing, وهو أعلم بهم سبحانه وتعالى. من أين جئتم, where are you coming from, oh my malaika? They say, oh Allah, جئنا من عند عباد لك في الأرض يسبحونك ويكبرونك ويهللونك ويمجدونك ويسألونك. We came, oh Allah, from slaves of yours on earth. They do tasbih of you, they do dhikr of you, they do tahleel of you, they do praise you. Huh? He says, وماذا يسألونني? Allah tells them, what are they asking me? And he is all knowing سبحانه وتعالى. قالوا يسألونك جنتك. They tell him, Ya Allah, they're asking you for your Jannah. اللهم أنا نسألك رضاك والجنة. He says, وهل رأوا جنتي? Have they seen my Jannah? Allah asked the Malaika. They said, لا, no, Ya Rab, they have not seen it. He says, فكيف لو رأوا جنتي? So how would it be if they had seen my Jannah? Because Jannah has an eye, has not seen, and an ear has not heard. قالوا ويستجيرونك. They say, oh Allah, and they seek refuge to you. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. قال ومما يستجيرونني. Allah tells them, and he's all knowing, from what are they seeking refuge in me? They said, Ya Allah, من نارك, from your hellfire, from your punishment. He says, وهل رأوا ناري? Have they seen my punishment, my hellfire? They say, لا, no. He says, how is it if, فكيف لو رأوا ناري? How is it would it have been if they had seen it? قالوا ويستغفرونك. Then the malaika says, Ya Allah, they seek maghfirah. They seek your forgiveness. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, Allah says, فيقول قد غفرت لهم. I have forgiven all of them. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك ونستهديك ونستغفرك ونتوب إليك. فأعطيتهم ما سألوا وأجرتهم مما استجاروا. Allah tells them, I have forgiven them all, and I will grant them what they asked of me, and I will give them refuge from what they seek refuge to me from. This, اللهم نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. فيقولون, شوف الملائكة هذه, لا, Allah told them, خلاص, everyone is forgiven, بسم الله, and they want جنة. They don't want nar, they don't give them nar. One of the malaika fayaqulu rabbi fihim fulan. Oh Allah, there is one amongst them. Abdun khatta. He's a sinful slave. Yani he's not part of the people that gather all the time and they do dhikr of you. Innama marra fajalasa ma'ahum. But he was passing by and he happened to sit with them. The malaika are telling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hadith Sahih Muslim hadith, huh? Still, we're still in Sahih Muslim. Allah tells him, فَيَقُولُ وَلَهُ غَفَرْتُ, and I have still forgiven him as well. هُمُ الْقَوْمُ لَا يَشْقَى بِهِمْ جَلِيسُهُمْ. He tells them, I have forgiven him because of them. So you don't know who in this majlis, one person maybe, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives the whole people because of them. Maybe one child you have, maybe someone young, Allah loves him, and he's doing istighfar, and Allah forgives everyone because of them. This is وَذَكِّرْهُمْ بِأَيَّامِ اللَّهِ. Remind them with the days of Allah. This is the benefit of coming to the masajid. This is the benefit of being reminded with the days of Allah. Someone may say أَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ. Allah forgives him, and because of him he forgives all of us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us all. الحافظ ابن رجب الحنبلي again says in his book لطائف المعارف, he says وليلة النصف من شعبان كان التابعون من أهل الشام كخالد بن معدان ومكحول ولقمان بن عامر وغيرهم يعظمونها ويجتهدون فيها في العبادة. He says the night of نصف, ابن رجب الحنبلي, big known scholar, he says the night of نصف من شعبان, the تابعين, the followers of the صحابة, so it's not from just now generations, the tabi'een, from the people of Al-Sham, like Khalid bin Ma'dan, Makhul, Luqman, they used to glorify that night and would do so much worship in that night. And this is also paralleled by Imam Shafi'i. Imam Shafi'i says in his book Al-Umm, volume 2, page 485, he says, we heard that dua is answered in five nights, Al-Shafi'i is saying. In the night of Jumu'ah, night of Eid al-Adha, Eid al-Fitr, the first night of Rajab, and the night of Nisf in Sha'ban. Imam Shafi says, dua is mustajab. We said that, we read that in the first hadith, هَلْ مِنْ سَائِلًا فَوَعْطِيَهْ. Is there anyone who's asking me anything so I can grant him? Today is your night to make istighfar, first istighfar. Don't go on your checklist, Ya Allah, I want a car, and I want a house, and I want... Okay, you can do it, but first istighfar. هَلْ مِنْ مُسْتَغْفِرٍ. لَأَنَّ your real Eid is when Allah forgives your sins. Everything comes next. You ask Allah مَغْفِرَ. If you ask Allah مَغْفِرَ, yes, then ask Allah for whatever you want. Your car, or house, on the lake, or five bedrooms, or six, all these things, no problem. Or job, or degree. Whatever you want, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala everything today. Lakin before, ask Him for maghfira. Be persistent, cry. Let your tears enter. You cry on everything now. Cry. If you can't cry, force yourself to cry. Stay you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one else, man. We need to have some time with Allah. Jalla Jalaluhu. We have time with everything and for everything. Lakin with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hatta salah, we do it supersonic. Anta you on the salah, you are bismillah, Allahu Akbar. طيب انت امان. Tonight is a night of forgiveness, maghfira, love, letting down all these, dropping the hate, dropping the grudges. Take some time with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Feel the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is close to you. That's a fact. وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْكُمْ. The point is not that He's close to you. That's not the point. The point is, are you close to Him? We know he's close to you. But the question, are you close to him? Try to have that sometime. No, you might not. How many people are with us tonight, this time, in this Sha'ban of this year? And last year, some people were with us, they are not with us this year. And some people before the year, they were there, but the year before were there, and the year that were not. People, you don't know whether you're going to be able to make it to the next of Nisf of Sha'ban or not. Make that opportunity. Use your time wisely. Now, الشافعي says, وأنا أستحب كل ما حكيت في هذه الليالي من غير أن يكون فرضا. He says, I encourage you to do these things, يعني ask forgiveness, etc. Or ask dua, make dua, especially in these nights, among them نصف شعبان, without it being فرض. It's not فرض to assemble or to gather in the night of نصف of شعبان or to have any specific thing. But it is the sunnah is that Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that you will be forgiven if you ask. The same thing what Ibn Nujaym في البحر الرائق, Ibn Nujaym al-Hanafi, as you all know, also mentioned that about al-mandubat. He says, وَمِنَ al-mandubat, it's mandub, he says, it's encouraged, ihya, spending out the night of nisf in Sha'ban, nisf min Sha'ban, as the ahadith mentioned. Similarly, Ibn Abidin al-Sharbini also في المغني and Shams al-Din al-Ramli. I don't want to go quote all these a'imma because we already talked about the ahadith. وكلام الأئمة للاستئناس للتأسيس لكتاب الله تعالى وسنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So the point is this: you saw many of the أئمة saying, number one, that this is a night where istighfar is given. What you ask may be granted. Many of the Salaf used to spend that night even in a congregation or so to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness. At least that's what we take from Al-Hafidh ibn Rajab's statement. Yustahab. So he must have had that from the Salaf. And the Salaf used to spend extra worship like Khalid bin Ma'dan, as Ibn Rajab says, etc., etc. Ushaq bin Rahoya used to say that. Since that's the case, spend that time in the night of Nisf of Sha'ban. If you're not in the masjid alone, go home alone, spend it in worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You sleep all the nights of the year. Give one night to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm not saying make it a fard or an obligation. Spend another night also for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's okay. No, we give all the nights we're on the mattress. We spend one third of our life sleeping. And if you live 60 years, 20 years you're sleeping. Give 20 years, give a couple of days. Now, give a couple of nights. This is one of the nights that you should give. Don't let the nights of Nisf of Sha'ban or Laylatul Qadr pass you without taking advantage of them. Don't let people tell you that Nisf Sha'ban is like any Nisf. Because those who believe, after the hadith is authentic, believe that Nisf Sha'ban is like any other Nisf of night, they have Nisf Aql as well. Probably. No. After the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's hadith, no one says more. It's a deal is done. لا تقدموا بين يدي الله ورسوله. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, tells us that this is a special night which istighfar may be answered. He's giving you a hint. Make istighfar in this night so you may be forgiven. Spend it in istighfar. Spend it in qira'at al-Quran. Spend it in ta'at to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, how about the day of? That's about the night. How about the day of Nisf Sha'ban? Should we fast? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, وَأَن تَصُومُوا خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. If you fast, it's better for you. Always fasting is better than not fasting. If I ask you a question, is fasting better or not fasting better? Any day of the year, fasting is better. Except the days that are Muharram, obviously. Very nice. Since fasting is better in general, what is the best month to fast in? Ramadan. We agree? Alhamdulillah. Very nice. After that, after Ramadan, what is the best month to fast in? Sha'ban. So Ramadan is the month of fasting had a fard. There's no argument about it. But an Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to fast in Sha'ban almost as Ramadan, almost as much as he fasted Ramadan, he fasted in Sha'ban. يعني Sayyidah Aisha says in the authentic hadith, I have not seen the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم fasting in any month after Ramadan like he fasts in the month of Sha'ban. So should you fast the nisf of Sha'ban? Please fast the nisf and the beginning and everything if you can, except few nights, huh? Normal. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us where Nasa'i narrated with an Hassan Sanad through Usama bin Zayd radiallahu anhu. He says, I asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Usama is asking Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Lam araka tasumu shahran min ash-shuhuri ma tasumu fi Sha'ban. I have not seen you fasting any other month like you are fasting in Sha'ban. Nabi al-Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells him, Thalika shahrun yaghfalu anhu an-nas. That's a month where people are absent in ghafla. They don't realize what they have. بين رجب ورمضان. It's between Rajab and Ramadan. People are in ghafla from this month. وهو شهر ترفع فيه الأعمال إلى الله. It's a month that the deeds are given to Allah. Your deeds are given to Allah. He says, فأحب أن يرفع عملي وأنا صائم. I love for my amal to be shown to Allah while I am fasting. Special also characteristic for the month of Sha'ban, as this Hassan hadith tells us, it's a month where your deeds, your specific deeds, are shown to Allah, though Allah is all-knowing. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us what? I like for my deeds to be shown to Allah, I'm fasting. What day are your deeds shown during the month of Sha'ban? We don't know. So fast most of Sha'ban. Huh? Nisf of Sha'ban is part of it? Yes. Let me tell you this hadith. You all know الحديث اللي أخرجه البخاري through أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه. He says, أوصاني خليلي صلى الله عليه وسلم, my beloved companion gave me a wasiyya, gave me a will before he left صلى الله عليه وسلم. Among the things, صيام ثلاثة أيام من كل شهر, that I should fast 3 days from every month. Look at this wasiyya. I should fast 3 days from every month. Now we established that Siyam Sha'ban in general is important. Now there are hadith telling us that fasting 3 days is very important in every month. But let's see which 3 days are those. Huh? This hadith is also an authentic hadith. Naam. Jarir ibn Abdullah with an authentic hadith. نعم الحافظ ابن حجر authenticated and others, والحديث cannot go, does not below the Hassan irrespective of what anybody says. يعني in sense, عن جرير بن عبد الله أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, صيام ثلاثة أيام من كل شهر صيام الدهر. If you fast 3 days of every month is as if you're fasting the whole, your whole lifetime. But wait, أيام البيض, the white days. الحديث is not done. صبيحة ثلاثة عشرة وأربع عشرة وخمسة عشرة. The 13th, the 14th, and طب this is the hadith. نصف شعبان, what day is this? Can we put one and one together or we can't? شعبان fasting in general, كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم used to fast شعبان more than any other month. Period. Huh? In general fasting. Now there is higher specification for 13th, 14th, and 15th of every month to be fasted. Is Sha'ban part of the months as well of the year? Since it's part of the months of the year, and Nisfu Sha'ban is a special night, and there is a specificity to fast 13th, 14th, and 15th of every month, doesn't that give you a higher encouragement to fast the Nisf of Sha'ban, since it's a special night, and anyway you're encouraged to fast the 14th, 13th, 14th, 15th? Hadith Abu Dharr also, Sahih, in the same thing, Ibn Rajab says, وَأَمَّا صِيَامُ يَوْمٍ نِصْفِ مِنْهُ فَغَيْرُ مَنْهِيٍّ عَنْهِ. يعني he says, fasting Nisf of Sha'ban, no one can bring a prohibition. There's no hadith says you cannot fast Nisf of Sha'ban. Because nowadays, unfortunately, again, we're having this notion, do not fast Nisf of Sha'ban. I want to fast 13th, 14th, 15th. Is there a problem with that? No, don't fast Nisf. I want to fast Nisf of Sha'ban. No. What do you mean no? طب there's a hadith says sunnah to fast 13th, 14th, 15th. There is no prohibition. There's no hadith says tells you don't fast the nisf of Shaban. Okay. Now there's a specific hadith here. We have a hadith telling us, you all know the hadith, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam tells us الحديث اللي رواه البخاري عن أبو هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه. He says لا يتقدمن أحدكم رمضان بصوم يوم أو يومين. None of you should fast Ramadan the last few days of Ramadan. One day, last day of Ramadan, or last two days of Ramadan. You all know this hadith in Bukhari. يعني if you fast Sha'ban entirely, make sure you don't fast the last day of Sha'ban and not the day before the last day. Right? Look at this hadith. الحديث في صحيح مسلم. And that's through Imran bin Husayn رضي الله عنه. He says رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم told him أصمت من سرر شعبان. Did you fast the سرر of شعبان? What is the سرر of شعبان? The middle of شعبان. سرر in the Arabic language could mean either end or middle, but end it cannot be because النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم already told us you cannot fast the end of شعبان. Don't fast the last day before Ramadan, huh? So then it can only be taking on the middle of Sha'ban. And that's in Sahih Muslim. أَصُمْتَ مِنْ سُرَرِ شَعْبَان. Did you fast from the surah of Sha'ban in the surah of Sha'ban? All right. So, having said that, let me just finish this because we don't want to take it. We don't want to make this an academic discussion today. But the brothers asked me to go over some of the evidences because of the notions about the Sha'ban and its specificity. It's a night where if you've been, hopefully you've been fasting the 13th, 14th, and 15th. Also spending the night in istighfar. These things are among the sunan that have authentic hadith in them. Please spend those nights. Please be reminded by those days of Allah. Call your friends, people that you care about. Tell them, make istighfar today. You don't want to come to the masjid, don't come. Make istighfar. Better if you come. You don't want to come, we still love you. But make istighfar. Seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this night. The whole year you're doing everything else. We don't know if we're going to live next tomorrow or the day after. Allah knows. Let's take some time tonight in istighfar, maghfiratu Allah. And let's ask Allah for everything. Ask Allah first of all for the reforming in your heart to make your heart nurani. To make your heart close to Him. To make your heart close to His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To make your heart filled with love and ihsan. Nothing is fard to do on this night. You don't have to do anything. Fard, special. But if it's an opportunity that you may be forgiven, why waste that opportunity? If I tell you there's down that street at the mall, Mississauga Mall, they're giving, Macy's is giving 75% off. 90%, do you have Macy's here? Now what do you have? Marshalls? Nah, Marshalls, we're low-end stuff. We want to go to higher-end stuff. Huh? All right, Sears, okay. I can tell you Sears are giving 90% discount. Just go. Everyone's going to go down to Sears. You have a discount, you have sale today in the sense that if you ask Allah maghfirah and you're sincere, Allah will forgive you. Please make sense. First make tawbah. Do first repent. Do tawbah to Allah. Because we are filled with sins. And every day we do sins. Repent to Allah, ask Him forgiveness. But don't ask Him forgiveness only with your tongue. Don't just say astaghfirullah. You know how we say it. Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. La, don't do that. Do istighfar with your heart. Let your heart do istighfar first and let your tongue be the reflection of the state of your heart. Do istighfar with your heart to Allah. Really repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once you repent to Allah, then ask His maghfirah. Ya Rabbi atubu ilayk. Ya Allah, please, I'm repenting back to you. Go down in sujood. Allah likes yourself, you, to humiliate yourself between Him, in front of Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Go down. And take time in your ruku'ah. Take time in your sujood. Make dua, ask him whatever you want. But humiliate yourself to him. Put yourself in his presence. That he is watching you now. He is witnessing you now. He is looking at you now. He is closer to you than you are to yourself. So please take this time today, few minutes istighfar. Before that also, before, so you can be eligible for maghfirah, drop the hate, drop the grudges, drop things like that. Let's just do maghfirah, let's do istighfar, let's ask Allah for things. If you have a health issue, ask Allah, today is your day. If you have you want to pass a test for those students, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You want to buy a house, you want to get married, ask Allah. You want to get divorced, ask Allah to make things right between you and your wife. Don't ask Allah for divorce. Huh? Ask Him to make things right. Ask Him to clear the hearts. Ask Him to purify the souls. Ask Him to make things good for you. Not in the way you think, but in the way He knows. Huh? What we think maybe is imperfect, not maybe. But what He knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the best. So ask Him to give you the best. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى الحمد لله رب العالمين.